inheritance issues with siblings, family disputes over property. That's our topic today. Let's get started right after this. Hi, I'm Kim Ward, developer of ProbateBiz.com, an online training for real estate agents to have a successful business helping others with properties in probate, like my business. Welcome back to my channel. Inheritance issues with siblings and family disputes over property. This can be a challenging situation for both the executor or administrator and you as the real estate professional involved in the transaction. So I'd like to talk about when two people inherit a home and only one of them wants to sell. A few years back, I was attempting to help an executor with a home in probate, and his sister didn't want to sell the property. They both had two different real estate agents trying to help them. I had been introduced to him by an attorney who is an advocate of the work that I do. The whole thing turned into a bit of a mess, and eventually I backed out of the situation because it was too time consuming, and the sister, turns out she was an attorney in another state, and she just wouldn't allow the situation to go forward. Now, there are ways around that, and we'll talk about that in a minute. So what do you do when you are helping someone that wants to sell one of their loved one's homes that has passed away, and somebody else that is a beneficiary or an heir does not? This can get awful tricky, and as you can imagine, is somewhat controversial. And at some point, the probate courts may have to step in to make it happen. So typically what happens is a listing is taken by the person that's here in this area, and then I would be contacting the other person, and that's when I might find out that they're not as excited about selling the family home. Now, in most cases, it gets worked out and we move forward with the sale. It's just about being sensitive to that other person's feelings about the family home and letting them work through their process. In extreme cases, the probate courts may need to step in. It usually starts out with the attorneys trying to work out the situation so that everybody's a little bit more happy, or the person that doesn't want to sell actually just gives in and lets it go through. Now, your part is, first, you have to determine if that other party is a beneficiary and they do have some right to the real property, the home of the decedent. That's where the attorney can help you to determine who the beneficiaries are of the particular estate. They'll probably look at whether there is a will. If there is, that would determine who does have a right to the property. I'm working on a sale right now in Lakeside, California, that the daughter of the decedent was actually written out of the will. And a strange thing occurred. She actually broke into the vacant house and started moving her things in there. She was removed by six police officers who told her that if she would return to the house, she would be arrested. So that's kind of a strange circumstance that does occur from time to time. But in that case, she was specifically written out of the will, probably for good reason. If in that particular case she pushed forward on that, the probate courts would enforce the decedent's last will and testament. If there hadn't been a will, then chances are she would have received a portion of the proceeds from the sale of the property and the estate. But since the decedent had written her out of that will specifically, she wasn't entitled to anything. So let's go back to when the will specifically says that two different people have a right to the property. I recently was representing a probate. Dee was appointed as the executor of the estate. When I went further into the documentation, I saw that there was also a 50% ownership of the house in a trust. So I reached out to that person, and that was the decedent's daughter. Now, she wanted to sell the house. As it turns out, Dee kind of just wanted to have the house listed so that she didn't have to sell it because the courts had been pushing her via her attorney to sell the property. So she was kind of playing a little game with me that I took the listing and was representing Dee. And then through weeks of phone calls and trying to figure out what was happening here, it was determined that Dee really didn't want to sell the house for whatever reason. That circumstances turned out that the listing actually expired, and I did not request that Dee extend that listing. I recently found out she listed with someone else, but the house hasn't come on the market either. Maybe that person should have called me first and found out what the circumstances had been. So these are extreme circumstances. Two times in the last 5 years that I've had kind of unusual circumstances where somebody really just didn't want to sell. I know this is more of a rambly video that I'm doing for you, but I'm just trying to share with you my personal experience. If you find this of value, go ahead and like this video, hit that subscribe button, and to get notified weekly, hit that bell button. I also would love to see your comments below. And if you have questions, just put those below. Also, I'll be sure to answer them. There have been cases where the attorney has to submit to the courts a request to partition the estate. When I am involved in a circumstance that is beyond what my licensing allows me to do, that's when I reach out to the attorney and ask for help. I am fairly confident in the circumstance with Dee that eventually someone will help with selling the property. And what will happen at that point is that the decedent's daughter will get her 50% of the proceeds and Dee will get her 50% of the proceeds. Of course, after all the closing costs and expenses, and because of Dee's actions, there will be more probate court expenses because of filings of paperwork, extending the letters of administration, and more. The other option is, with Dee, is that the courts will partition the estate, and this can get very messy and many hurt feelings. So I certainly hope in their case that they can work things out and resolve the real estate issues. And in case of a partition, the courts will typically not make two or more people continue to own real estate that they don't want to own. So in their case, I'm sure the courts will either force a resolution or the property will eventually be sold to a third party. I hope you enjoyed this. Go ahead, subscribe. I'll have another video for you next week all about probate.